Hi guys, my name is Chris Ord. Today I'm going to talk to you a little bit about the new Visico 2 strobe, which is available right now from Lenkara. So the Visico 2 is the latest in the new range from Visico portable battery powered strobes. Now I've already worked with the Visico 4 and Visico 5 previously over the last 12 months, so it was great to see when the Visico 2 was first announced. Now the first comparisons you might see is it looks a lot like, feels a lot like, shoots a lot like the Godox AD200. And actually that's the market they're going after, so they're looking for a slightly different option to the Godox AD200 Pro. Now those who know my work know I pretty much shoot exclusively with Godox product, so it's interesting to see how this weighed up against the AD200 and the 200 Pro. Now in terms of size and weight, the difference is nominal, and there's very little difference in the weight and size compared to the AD200, so that's something that doesn't really come into play too much. Now, one of the first things you might notice is that it comes with a round head. Now, it's a fixed round head. This isn't an interchangeable head. You can't put a Fresnel head or anything on there. But it means that it's compatible with the Godox S2 bracket, which works with the likes of the AD300 Pro, the AD200, which means I can clamp this round head into the bracket and use my normal modifiers with that, which makes it much more versatile to use. And another good thing about this round head, it works with the Godox AKR1 kit, meaning I can use grids, bond doors, gels and things straight on through a magnetic attachment. So if I didn't want to use a modifier or a softbox with it, I can still control the light to some degree with that fantastic kit. And I've put a link to that kit down below in the description. So just looking through the spec, because I literally got my hands on this and shot it before I'd even looked at the spec of this, it does everything you'd expect it to do. It shoots TTL and manual, and it also offers high speed sync up to 1/8000th of a second, which is becoming more the industry standard these days. On one charge, you'll get up to 500 full power flashes, so again that weighs in very closely to the AD200 Pro. It also has a 6-stage modeling lamp, which works really well if you need to use continuous light, much like I am now with these lights to light up myself for this video. Now it does work with its own wireless system, and one of the drawbacks is that it isn't compatible with a Godox range in terms of triggers and systems. However, there are workarounds around this, and there's other ways you could use this if you'd already had Godox kit and you just wanted to add something a little bit cheaper to the range. If you're buying a flash for the first time, this is a really viable option for that. You know, coming at just under £200 here in the UK, it's a very, very powerful flash for that price. And the fact that it's so portable, so light, and so easy to use is a massive advantage for that too. Now, I used this in the studio this week for a headshot shoot with the model Steph, and I wanted to see just what it was capable of, both in standard sync speeds and in high speed sync, because that's when I'd be more likely to use it. So I only shot one single setup with this in both high speed and standard sync speeds, just to see what it was capable of. Now, my first impressions, it was easy to use, it was responsive, it was easy to handle. Probably one of the only things I did notice was a slightly, ever so slightly longer recycle time on the flash, because I was shooting at half power. And as you know, when we're shooting in higher powers with high speed sync, it does tend to drain the battery a little bit quicker. But when you look at the specs across the time, recycle time on the V2 is 0.01 seconds to 1.8, which is directly comparable to the AD200 Pro, which offers the same sort of recycle times. It's actually specified at the same recycle time. Now, in terms of power increments, it has 8 stops, going from 128th power all the way up to full power in third stop increments. I mean, it's nice and easy to control that power, particularly from the trigger on top of the camera. Now, it works with its own trigger system, which is compatible with the Visico 4 and Visico 5. I know a few of you bought the Visico 5 on the back of my recommendation when I looked at it last year, so this would be an ideal addition to that kit if you wanted to grow your range of lighting that little bit more. Now, as I said earlier on, it offers manual, TTL and multifunction too, so if you want to use this for strobe topic functions, it offers that as well. Now, whenever I look at kit, I review kit, or I decide whether or not I'm going to use it, I look at 3 different things. First of all, does it do what I want it to do? And you know what, for me, light is light. It's one of those things that if you can turn on, you can power and flash when I wanted to, then it does the job pretty much. So most lights hit that bill. Is it easy to use is the next one. Now, for the most part, it is very easy to use. You can use a trigger system, which is very intuitive, very easy, works on a wind wheel, which means I can change the power as and when I need to. The menu system is a little bit more difficult to navigate, especially if you don't have the manual there. So you do have to refer to that if you want to get into the bones of the menu. So it takes a little bit longer to get used to for that. And my third thing is it easy to transport? Now, all of my lighting is battery kit. I don't work with any powered kit, particularly on location. So I'm always looking for something that's portable, that's lightweight and easy for me to set up and shoot on the go. And again, it hits that bill. Like I said, with the exception of the menu system, which really doesn't stop you using the strobe at all. That's the only downside I see to the strobe. Now, as I mentioned, at just shy of £200 here in the UK, it's substantially cheaper than the Godox AD200Pro. And my recommendation would be for someone looking to get into a more powerful flash system, but doesn't necessarily want to spend the money on an AD200, AD300Pro, then this would be a great introductory flash to use. Now, the benefit, if you do want to grow your kit after that and you do want to use Godox kit after that, this would still work on slave mode, meaning you can still use this very simply. So all in all from me, does it get a thumbs up? It absolutely does. For the price, and this is probably the biggest selling point, but I wanted to go on about it the least. At the price, for what it offers in comparison to the AD200Pro, it's a no-brainer. The only limitations are if you want to grow your range, there isn't as much to offer as there is with the Godox range, but you do have the Visico 4 and Visico 5, which are already there, which work on the same trigger system. Now, like I said, this is available right now from Lenkarta here in the UK, who also ship worldwide, and I'll put a link down in the description to their website. Thanks very much for watching. If you've got any questions, please don't hesitate to drop me a comment below, and I'll try my best to answer that as soon as I possibly can.